Jeff Gaskin. My first term, I'm a year and a half into my first term as mayor here in South Point. I've lived in the village for almost 60 years. This is our fourth or fifth year here, putting on a party in the park. We get a little bit bigger, we get a little bit better every year. The best thing about it, it's free. We don't charge for any of it. There are people here that might make a little bit of money, but we don't charge for it. We try to take care of the park. The people for the point actually put on the party, and they use the money that they make to put back into the park, to put back into our recreational area here at the village. So we always have a good time. We're fortunate this year that we were supposed to rain, and it hasn't yet. So we have a good time. Again, we don't charge anything for it, and we get people from all over. All these people here aren't from South Point. We get people from all over the county. Our headliner tonight is very good. And the fireworks, I don't think, are second to none here in Lawrence County. About 11 o'clock after the headliner is done, we'll have the fireworks display. Very well worth hanging around South Point to watch. Well, of course, behind me are the petting zoo, pony rides. Of course, we have lots of businesses that have come out. Food. One of the things we're working on this year that I'm working on in Lawrence County, we're working to get a levy on the ballot for Lawrence County EMS. And one of the more important booths here today is asking the public to sign a levy to ask the commissioners to put a levy on the ballot. That will be a very important issue, I believe, come November. That's one of the things we're doing here. And we have a car show going. We have bands all day long, fireworks tonight, vendors, food. I ran out of money, and I had to go to the bank to get more money because I ran out of money eating. So, but I think I've got enough now to last me the rest of the day.
You should have joined in on the hot dog eating contest there.
Yeah. I asked a friend if he would hold my hair back while I threw up, you know, after I hit all those hot dogs.
So we have 10 hot dogs here. It's whoever can eat them the fastest.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Let's begin. Go, 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 go. Different techniques. I see some eating them whole. I see some dipping in water. Let's go, Butcher.
Whatever you do, don't throw up.
Come on, honey, you got it. Don't give up. Don't give up. 45 seconds. See him dipping it in the water now.
Come on,
Bartram's in the lead right now. He has five down. Champion, he came back to defend his title. He looks like he's doing a pretty good job. Coming up on 3.5 minutes, Drew has five down. He's still working, not slowing down. Where's Drew sitting at? How many has he got?
He's got three left.
Drew's got three left. Keep going, Drew. Defend that title.
Sun goes down, all the chicks and the cats are gathered around. All the hot dogs and the red soda
pop. You ate two!
Down the road to a hip cab. Hot dog! She's my
baby. We got a number on second place down there. Who's in second right now? Is anybody close? Robin's anybody close in second right now? Drew's running away with it. Okay, Flowers is beside him, only has four. Pick it up, Flowers.
Yeah, boy, God. Come on, Dave.
Don't let him beat you.
Come on, you're going to get the money.
Come on, Flowers. I think Drew's getting nervous. He's looking over at Flowers. Keep it in, Flowers. All right, we're past the 5 minute mark. Let's go. Let's give it up for him. Let's go. Let's make some noise and let him finish it out here. Seven and a half minute mark. Drew's almost done. He's got half one left. gotta swallow that this last bite. All right, once he swallows it, it'll be done. Defends his title at the 8-minute mark. All right. Everybody quit eating. We're going to count up to see who got second place here as well. All right, we'd like to thank Snack Shack for donating the hot dogs and having the hot dog competition. It's always fun every year. So let's give a big hand for Snack Shack.
My name's Jay Main. We've been doing this now. This is the fourth year we've been doing this car show. It's for People for the Point. Just a big community thing to get everybody together in the community. You know, just have a fun day for everybody. Kids, you know, all sorts of things for that. There's live music for everybody, food vendors, everything like that. Got some cars down here for people to look at, you know, just some fun stuff like that. So that's basically all we're doing, just something for the community, just to do something for it. So I think our numbers are down a little bit this year because of the weather. You know, they were calling for some rain today, and we've lucked out thus far and still had a decent turnout, not as good as we were hoping for, but I'm sure the weather, like I said, had a factor to play into that. But we still got plenty of cars here, and there's plenty of nice cars here, a lot of good cars to look at, and I think it's turned out well. We're actually doing the top 50 this year, which is a little more than what we've done in the past, because we, like I said, we thought we'd have a bigger turnout, but the weather kind of hurt us on that one a little bit. But we'll have a Best Paint Award, Best Interior, Best Engine. There's a Mayor's Choice, there's a People's Choice, and a Best of Show. We'll do a Best Bike Prize, a bunch of door prizes and stuff like that. I'm not sure if we're doing a Longest Driven. I think we may have done a Longest Driven too. I'm not sure. I haven't really got to check to see how far away. I know there was supposed to be a guy coming with a bike. I'm not sure if he showed up or not. They were supposed to come from Charleston. But you know, we'll have people from over to Ashland, Huntington, out Barbersville and stuff like that. Fairly local, but you know, they get out there a few miles at least. Me and my dad's just old, you know, I've always been into hot rods with Dad, grew up around him with him, and you know, we've had cars here and cars there, all sorts of different cars, and always got into it. So look at them. I mean, they're just beautiful cars down here. There's beautiful cars everywhere, you know, and just seeing a nice car that somebody's put a lot of work into, they put some sweat into it, and you know, they put their money into it, and probably more money than they wanted to put into it, and they'll never get that kind of money back out of it, but it's just the joy of doing it, you know, and it's kind of the camaraderie when you get down here with all the car people, and you know, it's just a good little place to be. Hopefully grow it some more and more every year, you know, and hopefully, you know, the weather won't kind of bite us in the butt next year like it has this year a little bit, but just keep making it a better show, get people coming from, you know, further away and stuff like that. Yeah. One thing we are doing this year that I'd like to encourage people to do, there's a local kid here. He just passed away last week, unexpectedly. Has a daughter, a fiance, and you know, we're doing a fundraiser for him. He was a good kid. He volunteered coaching peewee football and stuff around here. He's done a lot of things for the community, and we were hoping the community could come together in this time to come down here and help him out too. You know, we're taking up donations to help the family with medical expenses and funeral costs and stuff like that. Like I said, he was a really good kid, and hate it for his family, hate it, you know, for everybody that knows him, all his friends and everything like that. And hopefully we can raise some money to help him out. Brandon Penn was his name. He was 33 years old, so very, very unexpected and very sad and, you know, tragic. His little girl was, you know, I hate it for her. I hate it for his fiance. So we're just trying to do what we can to help him out. We've gotten a lot of good feedback in the past from it, so you know, that's been good. I'm glad to hear that. We're going up, not down, so that's the good thing. Come on down, have fun, guys. There'll be fireworks later on, and it'll be a good time. Be a good time.
Okay, I'm Robin Combs. I'm the treasurer of BB Car Club. This is Brian Hines, vice president, and Vicki Chapman, she's secretary. We're here to support any causes. We love to go out and support the causes, and that's the reason why we get a group together and come down and do this, and we do it as a group most of the time. We're located, our car club is based out of Burlington, Ohio, which is really, we have a South Point address, so we like to support our own. We have a cruise in from May through October, the third Saturday of the month, and they're located over at the Cuyahoga Mall in Catlettsburg, Kentucky, Cannonsburg, Kentucky. We take donations and we raise funds for our Christmas party in December. We support homeless children or needy children in the area, and since our club members are made up from the three states, we rotate around doing Ashland, Ohio, and West Virginia, for the kids. And we do not require you to even have a car to join our club. We just want you to have the love of the automobiles, and we like to pass that down to the young folk. We are a family-enriched group. Even at our cruise-ins, we do car races for the kids with Matchbox cars. We do free cake at 8. We really want to, commute the family support. Okay, they can contact me, Robin Combs. We also have a Facebook page for BB's Car Club. My email address is robincombs@hotmail.com. Our post office address is BB's Car Club, Post Office Box 119, South Point, Ohio, 45680.
And we have a meeting once a month. It's the third Tuesday at Wendy's there in Burlington. And it starts at 7 o'clock. And if anybody wants to join or wants to have more information, they can just come down there and see us there too.
Of course, we wanted to get bigger. We want to improve the park. Some of our equipment is getting old. We want to improve our playground equipment. We want to make it bigger. We want to make the party in the park the place to be on the 4th of July weekend. Our headliners get bigger every year. They keep costing more money every year. The car show, not quite as big this year as it was last year, but that's just sometimes how car shows go. Vendors are more improved. The food is wonderful. When the wind blows the right way, it's just a wonderful smell. We are working very hard to keep things moving here in South Point. We have a wonderful crew that can do anything. I haven't asked them to do anything that they haven't been able to do yet. It's just the people that work for us are great. We have a crew here today working for free for the point. It's a wonderful little place.